All right, now time for our digital dive. It is 5:04. If you haven't made a winter survival kit, now is the time to. No more procrastinating, especially with the snow that's falling and that dangerous cold that's on the way. Well, you can buy a survival kit, but it's easy to just put together one from what you have at home. I do that every single year. And the Minnesota Department of Public Safety has a great list that we have compiled for you. So here it is. Have candles and matches, a knife, a red bandana or cloth, something really easy to see, a bright color like this, a pencil and paper, a whistle, snacks, a cell phone charger, a couple of those if you can, and flashlights. Have spare batteries with that flashlight. And with that flashlight, here's a good tip, reverse the batteries so that you don't accidentally burn them out before you need them. How many times has that happened to us just in general? And a pro tip for you this morning, don't keep your emergency kit in your trunk when it's going to be really, I mean, dangerously cold out this week. Because you never know when your trunk could get frozen shut.
Oh, that's
a good
one. So keep
it in the actual cab of the car. And another big question that we address every year that kind of gets mixed answers is, if you're stranded, should you get out of your car? Should you stay in your car? Well, they're saying stay in your car. It's the best form of shelter, essentially.
Well, in this day and age where just about everyone has a cell phone, mm-hmm. better to call for help and hope someone
just
comes
wait it
to,
out.
To get you. All right, Ellery, good tips, easy things to forget. So thank you.